Hey everybody, I thought that today would be a good time to come on and talk about hair. Tomorrow I'm going to be coloring my hair, and this happens once every few months, once every couple of months. So I do something kind of different, and it's all natural, of course. But it got me thinking about the way that I take care of my hair, because there's a lot of things I do, not just oils and natural products, but there's a lot of things I do that is kind of not the norm. So I just wanted to let you guys know how I like care for my hair, okay? I do like it long, and it has not taken me that long to grow it out, and I attribute that to using less product, to washing it less often, and to using natural plant-based products when I do actually do stuff to it. So the first thing that I did years ago, because basically I'm just pretty lazy and I wanted long hair, but I didn't want to have to blow dry it every day or straighten it every day or, you know, all the stuff. I trained my hair to not have to be washed very often. I washed it today and I just put it up in a towel and I let it dry naturally. So this is, I guess, what natural hair is for me, without being straightened or any heat or anything like that. But I trained my hair to go almost during the winter, when I don't like go outside and sweat, pretty much almost a week before I have to wash it. And I know that sounds really gross, but I promise you, like, yeah, maybe by day 5, I'm looking a little greasy on the top, but that's easily remedied by dry shampoo, which you can make out of completely natural ingredients, by the way, like cornstarch, and you can use cocoa powder if you have dark hair. So there's all kinds of recipes out there. You can just Pinterest it. I'm just going to say Pinterest it if you want to use dry shampoo, but that will get you through the next couple of days. Here's what happens when you train your hair. If you're washing your hair like every single day, then your hair, it's like getting the signal to produce oil the next day. So that's why your hair gets greasy the next day and you say, oh, I can't go without washing my hair. Well, there's gonna be a period where you're gonna have to suffer through the greasy hair and just use the dry shampoo. And you do it gradually. So like where I was washing my hair every single day, I started stretching it out to maybe every other day, every 3 days, every 4 days. And it's just gotten to the point where, like, literally I washed my hair today. So what, it's Friday. The last time I washed my hair was last Saturday. I keep my hair up a lot too, so I don't know if that helps, but, you know, in the summer, it's more like 4 or 5 days. But I do feel like, number one, I'm saving money on my shampoo and conditioner, but number two, I just feel like because I'm not messing with my hair so much that it's healthier. And I don't do a lot of blow drying. I don't do a lot of curling or straightening. It only happens like the once. Like if I wash my hair the rest of the week, it's probably going to be either straight or curly. I'm not going to curl it or straighten it every single day. It's just going to be what it is. And then when it gets to looking kind of funky, it goes up in a bun. So that's kind of the first thing. That was the first hippie step that I took. It's because totally crunchy here. Seriously, if you're waiting a week to wash your hair, you're in the crunchy club. But this is my second tip. Okay, these are shampoo and conditioner from my company, which is Young Living, and that means that this is totally plant-based. Okay, it doesn't have any of the yucky sulfate things that are in it. It doesn't have artificial fragrance or anything like that. Nothing that's going to be harsh on my hair. Nothing that's going to strip it of anything that, you know, my hair needs. It's wonderful, and because I only wash my hair every week or so, I usually wash it like a couple of times in the shower just to make sure I do get it really clean, but this lasts me forever. And here's what I do. This is the plain lavender shampoo. They have like lavender mint, they have Copaiba vanilla. And so what I do is I just get this kind. This is plain lavender, and I add my own oils to it. So here are some oils that are good for your hair. Let me show them. I don't think I'll put all these in there, but I have tea tree is excellent for your scalp. Okay. It's great for kids. You can even make like a spray for this, of this, and then spray it on your kids before they go to school every day. Okay, tea tree. Lemongrass is really good for your skin. It's really good for your scalp. It's very stimulating. Rosemary is another one that is excellent for your scalp. Cedarwood is great for your scalp as well. This one, I don't know if it'll come up on Google for you if you just Google good scalp oils, but I heard that Palmarosa is really good for your scalp, especially, I can't say why, if you have scalp issues. And then peppermint is another one. So like the lavender mint conditioner has lavender and peppermint. So it gives you that tingly, refreshing feeling on your scalp, that minty cool feeling. So I basically, because I don't measure anything or, you know, have certain recipes, I just throw a few drops of whatever I'm feeling goes in my shampoo bottle, and then so that it doesn't, I should have a better setup, so that it doesn't get all like, and this isn't not gonna foam up like normal shampoo, so you kind of have to get used to that. It does foam up and get some suds and stuff a little bit. But anyway, I just rock it back and forth for about a minute and get those oils all mixed up in there. And so that's what I do. Shampoo and then condition, not like heavy condition. It's all I need, just a little squirt. So I try to towel dry. I try to not have to blow dry it. Usually I'll wash it at night and sleep in wet hair. Maybe with a towel on, or maybe with no towel, I don't know. Maybe I'm just lazy. But it does seem to make a difference in the health of my hair. Now, let's talk about henna, okay? It's time for me to henna. As you can see, maybe my grays are coming out. So henna does wonders on gray. It's completely natural, it's completely plant-based. If you get henna, you need to make sure that you're getting the body art quality of henna, okay? You don't want to get like cheapo henna that has other things added to it that aren't plant-based. It's not good for your hair. So I have found, this is my favorite brand. It's called from the Henna Guys. And the color that's on my hair now, which is several months old, I think the last time I did henna was in October. So it's been a while, and I usually don't go this long, but it doesn't fade, it's permanent. Or it does fade, but it takes a while. So henna is basically, it's just dirt. And this color is wine red, and that's what I'll be using tomorrow. I also have another color that is a bit darker. This is the deep red. So it's a little bit darker, and it's more like a burgundy color. I don't know. I'll do that one later. Okay, so check this out. This is what you're going to get when you get henna. It's a bag of dirt. Kind of like on Pirates of the Caribbean. It's a jar of dirt. And you get instructions. Follow the instructions on the back. I didn't know this because I always end up with the red kind. And this one is just pretty much you mix it up with some room temperature water, and you make sure it's the right consistency, and then you apply it to your hair. But a friend of mine got some that was brown, and it told her to mix it up and let it sit out for several hours. So you're just going to have to look at the directions. But basically, you're going to take this dirt, and this henna has several things mixed into it that are all plant-based, but it's different plants that will give it that nice, pretty red color. You're going to take this dirt. I would use, for this much hair, I would use the entire thing. So I think I'm just going to do maybe a root touch-up. I'm just going to do like maybe this much, okay? I'm going to mix it up in a bowl. It's going to look like chocolate pudding, for lack of a better descriptive term. And then I'm just going to apply it to the roots. And then I'm going to let it sit there for a really long time, like a really long time, hours, if I want. It says to leave it on 3 hours. So you're going to put it in a shower cap and you're just going to walk around your house with your diarrhea helmet on, because that's what it usually looks like when you do your whole head. And then after 3 hours, this is the fun part, you get to wash the dirt out of your hair. And it is exactly like washing soupy mud out of your hair. It sounds so gross, but you get used to it, okay? Your scalp will probably be stained a bit. It does stain orange, so you want to make sure and wear gloves, but that will all wash out when you end up washing your hair. And you don't want to wash your hair for 2 days, so you might have some stains on your scalp for a couple of days. It's fine, okay? It's a couple of days. It's worth it. It's beautiful. When you get done, your hair is super shiny. When you go out in the sun, oh my gosh, it is gorgeous. The sun really picks up those reds. Henna is naturally orange, so you kind of have like this really fiery undertone to it. It's really, really pretty. And best of all, it's all natural. Okay, so that is what I do to my hair. And that's how I take care of it. And I have decently healthy hair. So a lot of questions got asked lately, and I thought I would just go ahead and put it out there on a video and answer all the people at once. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you have any questions about henna or about the shampoo and conditioner or about the oils or about training your hair, I'd be glad to answer them. I am going to color it tomorrow, so I'll try to, I usually don't, but I'll try to put some before and after picks up so you can see the difference, because henna is a lot of fun. It is permanent and it does bleed as you wash it, but like, it's okay. It's stuff you get used to. All right. Okay, well, I'm going to bed soon, so I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching.